In the last Geocast, I introduced you to DeckGL. Let's start with a quick recap. DeckGL is an open source JavaScript framework that you can use to bring beautiful WebGL accelerated 2D and 3D visualizations of massive data sets to experiences built with the Maps JavaScript API. It comes with a variety of performant visualizations out of the box that are useful for representing all kinds of geospatial data, both individually and in aggregate. Today, we're going to take a look at how to integrate DeckGL visualizations into your web apps. It's easy to do, and it takes very minimal code. The app we're going to build uses DeckGL's scatterplot layer, which displays a set of latitude and longitude coordinates as points on a map. This is a map of all the trees in New York City, and what you're looking at is a rendering of about 20,000 data points. The dataset I'm using in this example is from NYC Open Data, a project from the City of New York that provides a ton of interesting datasets about the city. Incidentally, public datasets like this are offered by many local and national governments and are a great way to experiment with the different data visualizations provided by DeckGL. We'll begin with the basic JavaScript app that loads a map. If you aren't familiar with loading a map with the Maps.js API, take a look at the tutorial linked below. Taking a quick look at our package.json file, you'll see we've already included a couple DeckGL dependencies in our project. The core DeckGL library, the Google Maps overlay module, which implements the Maps.js API's overlay view, and the DeckGL layers module, which provides the visualization layer we'll be using today. There are also visualizations available in other DeckGL modules, such as aggregation layer and geo layers. For more info on all of the available layers, visit the layers catalog in the DeckGL documentation, which we've linked below. Next, we'll update app.js to import Google Maps overlay and scatterplot layer. And now we have everything we need to add our data visualization to the map. Each layer in DeckGL is made available as a class that we instantiate with an options object that sets things like styling, data source, behavior, and other things. Here, we're creating a new instance of scatterplot layer. You'll notice that our options also include an ID property. This ID is how DeckGL tracks state change in individual layer instances and is important if you're adding more than one visualization layer to your map. You can set it to anything you want, but keep in mind that it must be unique for every layer. If you don't supply your own ID, it will be set automatically to the name of the visualization layer by default. You'll also notice that the data property specifies the URL of the NYC Open Data API that we're pulling this data from. We just provide the URL, and DeckGL automatically orchestrates the HTTP request and awaits the promise for us. Pretty awesome. DeckGL also supports many other types of data sources, including arrays, promises, async iterables, and objects that implement the iterable protocol. The last option that I want to point out is getPosition. In this example, our data source returns an array of JSON objects that look like this, which DeckGL iterates over automatically when the Open Data API responds. The value of getPosition is a function that tells DeckGL where to locate the latitude and longitude values of the data point in each row of the dataset. So in this case, each row is a JSON object, and the coordinates are at d.the_geom.coordinates. All right, last step, Google Maps overlay. As I mentioned in the last Geocast, DeckGL implements the Maps.js overlay view, which creates a transparent rendering layer on top of the map that automatically syncs with user interactions like panning and zooming. When we create a new instance of Google Maps overlay, DeckGL instantiates overlay view and injects its WebGL rendering context into the overlay. So next, we pass in an options object, which can be used to specify various aspects of the overlay. But in this case, we're going to use only the layers property, which expects an array of DeckGL visualization layer instances. We only have one layer in this example, so we add it to the array. And now we run our app. So now that you've seen how easy it is to add DeckGL to your web apps, give it a try. You can find the full documentation of Google Maps overlay and some more examples of different visualization layers linked below. And if you give it a try, let us know in the comments. We can't wait to see what you build.
Hello.
Oh my gosh.
Do you mind just smiling, doing one sans dog as well? Just in case.
I don't know. He's probably better for publicity than I am.